Muy buenos días.
Good morning.
¿Cómo están ustedes?
How are you?
Qué bueno estar. Desde que entré por la puerta empecé a ver algo maravilloso de esta iglesia.
It's good to be since I just came in by the door, just started looking at something so wonderful of this church.
Todas las personas que me saludaron tenían una sonrisa en su boca.
All the people that say hello to me, they have a smile on their face.
Y eso me deja saber de que es una iglesia que tiene a Jesucristo en su corazón.
And that just let me know that it's a church that has Jesus Christ in their hearts.
Porque sé que todos tenemos problemas, pero cuando hay una sonrisa, eso significa que tenemos confianza en Dios.
Because we all have problems, but when there's a smile, it means that you trust in the Lord.
Y todos los que estamos aquí confiamos en Dios.
And everyone that is right here, we trust in the Lord.
O tal vez haya alguien aquí que esté por primera vez y hoy va a conocer a ese Dios que puede hacer sonreír aún en medio de los problemas.
Or maybe there's going to be someone that is here for the first time, but you will know today who is the one who have a smile in the face.
Para los que no me conocen, mi nombre es Félix Vargas.
For the ones who doesn't know me, my name is Felix Vargas.
Felizmente casado con la mujer más hermosa del mundo.
Happily married with the most wonderful and beautiful woman of the world.
Me he casado dos veces.
I married twice.
Pero con la misma mujer.
But with the same woman.
Que es ella.
And that is
her. La primera vez que me casé con ella no tenía Cristo en mi corazón y por ende no la amaba.
The first time that I married her, I didn't have Jesus Christ in my heart, so that's why I didn't love her.
Solamente me casé por conveniencia.
I just get married because it was convenient for me.
Pero la segunda vez que me casé con ella, ya tenía a Cristo en mi corazón y me casé convencido y seguro de que la amaba y iba a ser por toda la vida.
But the second time that I just get married with her, I just have Jesus Christ in my heart and I just get married knowing that is what it's going to be for the whole life.
De nuestra unión hay tres chicos. El mayor se llama Juan David, tiene 16 años.
From our marriage, it comes three children. The older one is Juan David, who is 16 years old.
Y tengo mellizos de 11 años, Laura Sofía, la niña, y Daniel José, el niño.
And I have Laura Sofía and Juan Daniel, who is 11 years old. They are twins.
Y hace 12 años conocí de Jesucristo.
And 12 years ago, I just have an encounter with Jesus Christ.
Lo conocí en un evento dentro de la iglesia del Nazareno.
I just found him. I have received Jesus Christ in an event inside the Church of the Nazarene.
Entonces, como decía el pastor, yo creo que en los eventos Dios también puede ganar personas para su reino.
So just like the pastor says that maybe at a big event, yes, Jesus Christ can find people and get into the hearts of them.
Desde que recibí a Cristo en mi corazón, a los 20 días el pastor Adalberto me llamó a trabajar en su grupo de liderazgo.
Since I accepted Jesus Christ in my heart, 20 days after it, Pastor Adalberto called me to be one of the 12 of the leadership.
A los 3 meses estaba predicando en la iglesia del pastor, bueno, en la iglesia que dirige el pastor Adalberto. Es la iglesia más grande dentro de nuestra denominación, con 19,000 personas.
After 3 months, I was preaching in this church, and well, let me tell you that the Church of Nazarene in Cali, Colombia, is the biggest church of Nazarene, and it's about 19,000 people right now.
Y desde ahí comienza toda mi carrera ministerial que ha sido de una bendición por Dios.
And since there I start studying and my ministry studies, and I start my career theological and everything of my preparation, and it's been a blessing from God.
Fui llamado al año y medio a pastorear en una iglesia en Riobamba.
I get the call to be a associate pastor in Riobamba.
También me llevaron a Argentina para desarrollar una estrategia a nivel de Sudamérica.
Even they took me all the way to Argentina so I can develop some kind of a strategy right there in South America.
A los 4 años y medio de haberme convertido, ya yo estaba siendo ordenado presbítero de la iglesia del Nazareno.
After 4 years and a half that I accept Jesus Christ, I get ordained by the Church of Nazarene.
Y ahí fui nombrado como coordinador o director para el área central de Sudamérica.
And then they named me like a director or coordinator for the South America central area.
Entonces ese ha sido mi ministerio. Ahora estoy desarrollando lo que es el ministerio de evangelismo, porque me apasiona el evangelismo.
And that has been my ministry, but right now I'm developing the evangelism ministry because I get passionate about it.
Entonces te he contado lo que ha pasado con mi vida en los últimos 12 años.
So I've been telling you what happened in my life in the last 12 years.
Pero te quiero contar cómo fue mi vida antes de estos últimos 12 años.
But I would like to tell you how was my life before those 12 years.
Y entonces para eso quiero invitarles a que abran sus Biblias en el libro de Hechos, capítulo 9, versículo 15.
So I would like you to open your Bibles or just look at the screen on the chapter 9, verse 15 of Acts.
Y voy a pedirle al Pastor Samuel que lo lea para ustedes en el idioma inglés.
And I'm going to ask Pastor Samuel to read it in English for you. And the word of God says this way, but the Lord said to Ananias, go, this man is my chosen instrument to proclaim my name to the Gentiles and their kings and to the people of Israel.
Esta palabra de Hechos 9:15 se convirtió en algún momento una promesa para una mujer.
This word of Acts chapter 9 verse 15, it becomes the promise for a woman.
Aquí el Señor está dando una orden a Ananías acerca de Saulo de Tarso.
Here the Lord is giving an order to Ananias about Saul of Tarsus.
Porque Saulo de Tarso en ese momento no era conocido como Pablo, sino Saulo de Tarso.
Because in that moment Saul wasn't known like a Paul or apostle of Paul. He was just known by the name of Saul of Tarsus.
Y era un hombre que estaba persiguiendo la iglesia.
And he was pursuing the church.
Y Dios le da esta orden a Ananías para que vaya y ponga sus manos sobre este hombre, sobre Saulo de Tarso.
And God is giving this order to Ananias to go and impose hands over Saul of Tarsus.
Con un mandato o diciéndole a Ananías el por qué tenía que ir a poner las manos sobre este hombre.
He was commanding him and telling him why he has to impose the hands over Saul of Tarsus.
Y este hombre, a pesar de que iba en contra de la iglesia, este hombre iba a ser instrumento poderoso de Dios para llevar el nombre de Jesucristo
and
a ser conocido.
Even though this man was against the church or pursuing the church, it was going to be a chosen instrument from God.
Pero esta palabra se convirtió, como les dije al comienzo, en una promesa para una mujer que la creyó durante muchos años.
And this word becomes the promise for a woman that she believed that all the years, for many years, that this is what's going to happen for her as well.
Y quiero comenzar hasta llegar al punto en que esto se convirtió en promesa para una mujer.
And I'm going to start all the way to the point when this became a promise for this woman.
Yo nací en un hogar lleno de muchos problemas.
I was born in a home that has a lot of problems.
Y uno de los problemas más graves fue que fui creciendo sin papá y sin mamá, es decir, con ausencia paterna y ausencia materna.
The worst of the problems, it becomes that I grew up without mother or father. I grew up with the absence of the mother and the absence of the father as well.
Padre ausente de mi hogar porque mantenía siempre tomando licor en las cantinas.
He never was in the house because he retained and he keep drinking and drinking every single day in other places.
No tenía tampoco mamá de cerca porque tenía que trabajar 20 horas al día para cumplir, para poder llenar las necesidades de un hogar.
And I didn't have a mother as well because she has to work overtime because she has to fulfill the needs of the house.
Entonces eso hizo que yo fuera creciendo en un hogar con ausencia paterna y con ausencia materna.
So that makes me that I was growing up in an absence of the father, absence of the mother because of these things.
Yo nunca tuve un padre, una madre que me abrazara.
I never had a father that hugged me.
Nunca tuve un padre, una madre que me felicitara cuando hacía algo bueno.
I never had a father or a mother that congratulated me when I do something good.
Yo nunca tuve un padre o una madre que me levantara cuando caía.
I never had a father or a mother that lift me up whenever I just
fui fallen. Creciendo con ausencia paterna y ausencia materna.
And I keep growing up without the absence of the father and with the absence of the mother.
Y para agregarle más dolor a esta situación.
And to put more pain on this situation.
Siempre vi violencia en mi casa.
I was look every single day the violence.
Yo nunca vi amor, yo nunca vi respeto.
I never saw any love or respect in the house.
Siempre veía un padre que golpeaba y golpeaba a mi mamá.
I just watched my father beating up my mother.
Entonces yo empecé a ver lo que era la violencia y empecé también a contemplar la violencia en mi corazón.
So I just look at the violence and watch at the violence and then I start feeling the same in my heart.
Porque mi motivación para crecer era ser grande, para devolverle a este hombre golpe por golpe que le daba a mi mamá.
Because the only motivation that keep me up to be growing up and be older and be stronger is just to beat him up him again because he was beating up my mother.
A la edad de 11 años quise defender a mi mamá de una golpiza que le estaba dando este hombre.
When I was 11 years old, I just tried to protect my mom when my father was beating up my mother.
Y cuando decidí defenderla a ella, este hombre viene a golpearme a mí.
And when I decide to protect her, this man came towards me.
Y le digo a este hombre porque nunca le llamé papá a él.
And I'm telling you this man because I never called him father.
Y este hombre se viene a golpearme.
And this man came to me.
Mamá se pone en medio entre él y yo.
And mom just get in between.
Yo pensé que mamá venía a agradecerme porque la quería defender.
I really believed that my mom was about to appreciate what I was doing for her.
Pero ella no vino a agradecerme.
But she never came to appreciate.
Ella me dijo, tú no te metas en esto, esto es entre tu papá y yo.
And then she told me, you don't get in this business because this is not your business. This is between your father and myself.
Y si me ponen a escoger entre tu papá o tú, prefiero a tu papá.
And if they push me to choose between your father and you, I'm going to choose your father.
Mamá prefirió los golpes de un hombre al amor protector de un hijo.
My mom just ready to have the punches of my father, that the protector love of the son.
Y allí empecé a sentir un nuevo odio.
And right there I start to feeling another hate in my heart.
Ya no era solamente odio por este papá, sino que empecé a odiar a mamá con toda la fuerza de mi corazón.
It was just not the hate that I feel for this man, but I start hating my mom with all my heart.
¿Para qué amar a una mujer que no me valoraba?
Why I have to love a woman that doesn't even value me or
¿Por qué amar a una mujer que prefería los golpes que al amor?
Why to love a woman that ready to have the punches that instead of the law?
Entonces huí de mi casa a los 11 años.
So I ran away from my house.
Llegué a la casa de un tío a vivir con él. Era un hombre militar.
I just got to the house of an uncle. He was a military man.
Él al verme llorar todos los días por mi tristeza.
When he saw me crying all the days because of my sadness.
Él me dijo un día, si tú quieres vivir conmigo, Félix, no te quiero ver llorar nunca más porque los hombres no lloran.
And then one day he told me, you know, Félix, if you want to live in this house, you have to stop crying because the man doesn't cry.
Y desde los 11 años me enseñaron a no llorar.
And since I was 11, they just taught me how not to cry.
Desde los 11 años me enseñaron a disparar toda clase de armas.
And since I was 11, they showed me how to shoot any kind of weapons.
Mi tío, al ser capitán, me enseñó a disparar desde muy chico. Desde los 11 años, yo sé disparar armas de fuego.
Since he was a captain, he showed me how to shoot any kind of weapons. So I understand and I knew how to shoot weapons since I was 11.
Disparé revólveres, pistolas automáticas, ametralladoras, fusiles.
I just shoot any kind of weapons, pistols, revolvers, machine guns, and snipers, anything.
Entonces me volví muy experto en las armas.
So I became an expert in weapons.
A la edad de 15 años tuve que dispararle a un hombre por tres ocasiones porque quiso entrar a robar a la casa de mi tío.
When I was 15 years old, I just had to shoot three times to a man that tried to come in the house.
Y nunca me habían felicitado.
And nobody ever congratulated me for something.
Durante mis primeros 15 años nunca hubo un padre que me felicitara, una madre que me felicitara, un tío que me felicitara. Nadie me felicitó nunca hasta ese día.
During my 15 years, nobody congratulated me. Not even my uncle, not even my father, not even my mother.
Pero ese día que le disparé a este hombre, todo el mundo me felicitó.
But that day that I shoot this man and kill this man, everybody says congratulations.
Entonces el niño de 15 años pensó que lo que había hecho era bueno.
So the boy of 15 years old believed that what he has done, it was good.
Terminé mis estudios y me fui al ejército para ser entrenado en contra guerrillas.
I just finished my studies and I went to the army so I can work out against the rebels.
Y allí comienza todo un entrenamiento para ir a las para combatir a la contraguerrilla, y pasé por entrenamientos en Israel por los Mossad.
And then I start my training to go against the rebels and I get trained by the Mossad from Israel.
También fui entrenado por SEALs del gobierno americano en San José de Costa Rica.
Then I get trained by the SEALs from the U.S. government in San José, Costa Rica.
Después me llevaron a Ciudad de Panamá, donde fui entrenado por Boinas Verdes del gobierno americano.
And then I get trained by the Green Beans in the U.S. government right there in Panama.
Termina mi entrenamiento con estos grupos especiales, estos grupos de fuerza élite, y soy llevado de nuevo a Colombia.
Then I finish my training by these groups, and then I just take me back all the way to Colombia.
Y por 10 años fui soldado profesional del ejército colombiano combatiendo a la guerrilla en la selva.
So I was for about 10 years a professional soldier of Colombia, and I just would get trained all everything just to make battle again the rebels.
Pero el gobierno colombiano también me traicionó como me traicionó mi mamá.
That as well, just like my mom did betray me, the government from Colombia betrayed me as well.
Yo amaba al ejército, yo amaba mi patria.
I loved the army, I loved my country.
Yo estaba dispuesto a morir por mi patria.
And I was even willing to die for my country.
Pero mi patria también me decepcionó.
But my country as well disappointed me.
Teníamos rodeado al guerrillero más buscado en ese momento en Colombia para matarlo o tomarlo prisionero.
We have surrendered the most wanted rebel from Colombia just to kill it or just take it like prisoner.
Cuando viene una orden presidencial que dice abortar la misión, replegarse.
So then a presidential order comes and he says abort the mission or just pull back.
Y tienen que sacar protegido a este hombre, no se le puede hacer nada a este hombre, no se le puede tocar.
And then they said you cannot touch this man, you have to protect this man.
Y este hombre fue sacado en un helicóptero Iroquois de la Cruz Roja en ese momento.
And they just took that Iroquois helicopter from the Red Cross.
Y a los tres meses este hombre se lanza como candidato a la presidencia de la República de Colombia.
And after 3 months, this man becomes a candidate to be the president of the Republic of Colombia.
Entonces este rebelde se iba a convertir en el presidente de Colombia.
So that rebel was about to be the president of Colombia.
Entonces tomé la decisión de irme del ejército.
So I just took the decision to go away from the
army. Y empecé a buscar trabajo en la vida civil.
And I started looking for a job in the civil life.
E encontré un trabajo bien chévere, bien bacano, como
and
decimos los
found
colombianos.
A cool job, an awesome job, like the American says.
Seguridad en una discoteca.
Security guard in a discotheque.
Y te digo, me gustaba ese trabajo.
And I can tell you, I really liked this job.
Y disfrutaba ese trabajo.
I enjoyed this job.
La función mía en el trabajo era la siguiente.
The function of myself was the next one.
Si un borracho se ponía aburridor, lo tomaba del cuello de la camisa, del cinturón del pantalón y pa' afuera, para la calle.
If there was a drunken man that gets so boring, I just took it from the t-shirt, I took it from the pants, and I just dropped it all the way to the street.
Y me gustaba sacar borrachos.
And I really enjoyed to take the drunken man's out.
Cuando un borracho no quería pagar la cuenta,
when some drunken man doesn't want to pay the bill,
entonces llamaban al grupo de seguridad, íbamos hasta donde estaba el borracho.
So they called the security, and then we went all the way to the table where the drunken man was.
Y le hacíamos pagar la cuenta con dolor o sin dolor.
And we just made him pay the bill with pain or with not pain.
Me gustaba más con dolor.
I really enjoyed with pain.
¿Por qué?
Why?
Porque todo lo que yo le hacía a un borracho se lo estaba haciendo a ese padre que odiaba.
Because everything, all the things that I did to this man, I was doing it to my father.
Entonces veía en cada borracho, veía a ese padre que yo odiaba.
So I see and I look on every single drunken man, the father that I hate.
Trabajando en esta discoteca conocí gente importante de la ciudad de Cali.
When I was working in the discotheque, I just started meeting some important people in the city of Cali.
Y entre ellos conocí a los guardaespaldas de los hermanos Rodríguez.
And between them I just met the bodyguards of the brothers Rodríguez.
¿Quiénes eran los hermanos Rodríguez en ese momento en
Who
la ciudad de Cali?
The brothers Rodríguez at that moment in the city of Cali?
Eran jefes del cartel de las drogas de Cali.
They were the bosses of the cartel of drug cartels in Cali, Colombia.
Y me dijeron esto, oye, ¿te gustaría trabajar con nosotros?
And then they told me, would you like to come and work with us?
Yo le dije, bueno, si hay oportunidad, me gustaría trabajar, ¿cómo no?
And I said, well, if there's a chance to go work, oh yes, I would like to.
Y empecé a trabajar como guardaespaldas del hermano mayor de los Rodríguez.
So I started working like the bodyguard of the older brothers of the brothers Rodríguez.
Y empecé a ganar mucho dinero.
And I started earning a lot of money.
Mucho, mucho dinero.
A lot of money.
Yo venía una familia de escasos recursos económicos y ahora el dinero me estaba deslumbrando.
I just came from the low resources family and now the money was shining in my life.
Empecé a vestir con ropa de marca, zapatos de marca, lociones de marca.
I started just wearing some brand new shoes and brand new clothes and brand new everything. Oh,
y a los 6 meses pude comprar mi primer auto.
And after 6 months, I just could buy my first car.
Mi primer auto fue un BMW 525 injection, deportivo, hermoso.
My first car was a sport car, that's a BMW 525 injection, so it was really beautiful.
Entonces todo esto deslumbró mi vida.
And all of that by my eyes.
Terminando los 80, comenzando los 90, se desata una guerra muy fuerte en Colombia.
When the 80s were finishing and when the 90s start, there becomes a big war right there in Colombia.
Guerra entre el cartel de Cali contra el cartel de Medellín, que su jefe máximo era Pablo Escobar Gaviria.
The war starts between the cartel from Cali against the cartel from Medellín, who the boss was Pablo Escobar.
Empieza esta guerra entre los dos carteles y ponemos al servicio del cartel de Cali todo nuestro entrenamiento militar.
Everything started and the war started and we put all this in the service of cartel of Cali, our military training.
Después de unos 5 o 6 años de guerra, de violencia entre estos dos carteles, muere Pablo Escobar en la ciudad de Medellín.
After maybe 5 years that being in war and violence in these cities, well, Pablo Escobar died in the city of Medellín.
Había habido un acuerdo entre unos gobiernos contra el cartel, con el cartel de Cali, si lográbamos capturar o dar de baja a Pablo Escobar.
There were some agreements between the governments and the cartel of Cali if we could kill Pablo Escobar.
Cuando muere Pablo Escobar, el día 15 de diciembre del año 93, a mí me llevan a la embajada norteamericana.
In the 15th of December of the year 93, they took me to the embassy when Pablo Escobar died.
Y ahí soy traído a Estados Unidos, a la ciudad de Miami.
And from there, from the American embassy, they took me all the way to the city of Miami.
Y llego a la ciudad de Miami a vivir mi vida de rico.
And then I get to the city of Miami to start living my
Tenía
life
mucho
like
dinero.
A rich man. I have a lot of money.
Allí conozco una mujer de origen puertorriqueño.
And then I met a woman that the origin was of Puerto Rico.
Yo había entrado en una adicción por las mujeres. Nunca me había enamorado de una, pero tuve una atracción por esta mujer.
I have to share with you that I had the addiction for many women. But in that moment, I just had the attraction for this.
Era primera vez que yo quería estar en una relación únicamente con una sola mujer.
It was the first time that I just wanted to be in relationship with a woman, just with
Ella
one
no era
woman.
Cristiana, yo no era cristiano.
She wasn't Christian, and I wasn't Christian.
El hecho fue que empezamos a vivir juntos.
So the deal was that we start living together.
En Miami cometí un error muy grande.
And in Miami, I just make a real great mistake.
Quise ser narcotraficante en la ciudad de Miami.
I just wanted to become a drug dealer in the city of Miami.
Yo no fui narcotraficante en Colombia.
I wasn't a drug dealer in the city of Colombia.
Yo prestaba seguridad a un narcotraficante, pero yo no era narcotraficante.
I just was the security guy of a drug dealer man, but I wasn't a drug dealer.
Y quise ser narcotraficante sin ninguna necesidad porque tenía buen dinero.
And I just wanted to become a drug dealer, and I didn't have the need to do it because I have a lot of money.
Y como no sabía nada del narcotráfico, le quise vender drogas a un agente secreto de la DEA.
And because I didn't know anything about the business, I just tried to sell my first time drugs to a secret agent from the DEA.
Y caí preso en la ciudad de Miami.
So I fell prisoner in the city of Miami.
Los primeros 6 meses me tuvieron en el hueco, incomunicado.
The first 6 months that they just put me in a hole with no communication.
No pude llamar a la boricua, a la puertorriqueña.
I couldn't call the boricua, the Puerto Rican woman.
No pude llamar al abogado.
I couldn't call any lawyer.
Después de 6 meses me dejan salir al compound.
After 6 months they let me go to the compound.
Y puedo hacer una llamada.
And I just be able to make a phone call.
Y llamé a la casa donde estaba la boricua.
And I just called the house where the Puerto Rican
Era
was.
Mi casa.
It was my house.
Y llamo y sorpresa para mí no me contestó ella, sino que me contestó un hombre.
And big surprise for me, she doesn't answer the phone, but he answered the phone.
Y yo dije, ¿y tú quién eres?
And I just say, who are you?
Y me dijo, yo soy el esposo de ella.
And then he told me, I'm her husband.
A los 6 meses.
After 6 months,
tenía otro hombre en mi casa.
She has another man in my house.
Andando en mis autos.
Driving my cars.
Y gastándose mi dinero.
And spending my money.
Segunda mujer que amaba.
Second woman that I love.
Segunda mujer que me traicionaba.
And second woman that betrayed me.
La primera fue mamá.
The first one was my mother.
La segunda fue la puertorriqueña.
The second one was the Puerto Rican.
Me condenaron únicamente a 10 años de prisión.
They make a sentence for me for only 10 years of prison.
Los primeros 3 años y medio nadie me visitaba.
The first 3 years and a half, nobody visited me.
Un día pasé cerca del salón de visitas y miré hacia adentro donde estaban compañeros míos en visita con sus familiares.
One day I just passed through the visitation room and I just saw that there was a partner of myself and had some visitation.
Y pasé allí y vi a mi compañero con su novia y otra mujer al lado.
And I just went right there and I just saw a partner of mine with his girlfriend and another woman on the side.
La otra mujer era tremenda afroamericana, hermosa ella.
The other woman was a tremendous Afro-American girl. Beautiful.
Yo dije, wow.
And I said, wow.
Yo me fui para el comedor.
I went to the dinner room.
Por la tarde me encontré al compañero.
And by the evening, I just found my partner again.
Le dije, oye, yo te vi con tu novia y otra mujer al lado. ¿Quién es?
And I just saw him. Hey, I saw you with the girlfriend and then another one on the side. Who's that?
Me dice, es mi cuñada.
Oh, he said, it's my sister-in-law.
Yo le dije, tu cuñada está como quiere, compadre.
And I just told her, oh, you know what? Your sister-in-law is like she wanted to be.
Llévale saludos.
So send her some greetings.
El próximo domingo él me dijo, te enviaron saludos.
The next Sunday he said, oh, she sent you greetings as well.
Yo le dije, llévale saludos.
And then I said, okay, send greetings again.
Y el otro domingo ya me mandó saludos.
And the next Sunday she sent me greetings again.
Yo le dije, no, esto así está muy aburridor, decirle que me mande un teléfono para llamarla.
And then I said, no, this is so boring, please. Tell her to send me a phone number so I can call her.
Y ella me mandó el número telefónico.
So she sent me the phone number.
La llamé.
I called her.
Pude hablar con ella.
I just be able to talk to her.
Me le presenté.
And then I just introduced myself.
Y terminando la conversación le dije, oye, ¿te gustaría venir a visitarme aquí a la prisión?
And when I just finished the conversation, I just told her, would you like to come and visit me in the prison?
Ella me dijo, ay, sí, qué rico, me gustaría ir a visitarte.
And then she said, oh, yes, so good, I would like to go and visit you.
Pon mi nombre en el libro de visitas.
Put my name in the book of visitation.
Y yo le dije, tranquila, eres la única que está en el libro de visitas, puedes venir cuando quieras.
And then he said, oh, you know what, take it easy. You are the only one in the book of my visitation just for me. Don't worry.
Y ella dijo, este domingo voy a visitarte.
And then she said, well, this Sunday I'm going to go and visit you.
Llegó el día domingo.
It comes a Sunday.
Me puse la mejor ropa que hay en prisión.
I just get the best clothes that is in prison.
Siempre la misma, pero ese día la planché con la mano y quedó bien bonita.
It's always the same, but that day I just tried to iron it with the hand, and it was so good.
Me dijeron, tiene visita.
And they told me, you have visitation.
Entré al salón de visitas, me senté.
I just get into the room and a visitation, and I just take a seat.
Ella va entrando.
She's coming in.
Pregunta por mí.
She asks about me.
Me señalan.
They point me.
Y se viene hacia mí.
And then she came towards me.
Tú tienes que entender que yo tenía 3 años y medio sin ver una mujer.
And you have to understand that I had 3 years and a half without looking at any woman.
Era un hombre mujeriego.
And I was a man that really liked the woman.
No era cristiano.
I wasn't Christian.
Imagínate todo lo que pensé en mi mente cuando ella venía caminando hacia mí.
Can you imagine how many things comes in my mind when she was walking towards me?
Yo decía, ahorita viene ella y me va a dar un beso con traqueotomía y todo.
I just said, she's going to come right here, she's going to give me a kiss with that tracheotomy and everything.
Y yo me sentí ahí.
And I just take a seat right there.
Y ella se acercó.
And she came close.
Yo la quise saludar así, mira.
I just wanted to say hello like this, look.
Pero ¿sabes cómo me saludó ella?
But you know how she say hello to me?
Cristo te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Yo dije, oye, esta, Cristo te ama.
And I just said, this is woman, how Jesus loves you.
A mí no me vengas a hablar de religión.
Don't come to me and tell me about religion.
A mí no me vengas a hablar de Dios.
Don't tell me about God.
Porque para mí Dios es un arma, para
because
mí Dios es dinero.
For me, God is a weapon. God is money.
Y empezó a visitarme cada domingo.
So she started visiting me every single Sunday.
Y yo esperaba nada. Cristo te ama.
And I was waiting for the nothing. Jesus loves you.
Y Cristo te ama.
And Jesus
y Cristo
loves
te
and
ama.
Jesus loves you.
Y yo decía, y bueno, ¿cuándo será que ella es la que me va a decir que me ama, no el tal Cristo?
And I just said, well, what is going to be that she's going to tell me that she is the one who loves me and not that Jesus Christ?
Y me siguió visitando y visitando.
And she kept visiting and visiting me.
Un domingo no fue.
One Sunday she doesn't
pasó
go
un mes, 2 meses, 8 meses en que nunca más volvió.
Then 2 months, 3 months, 8 months that she never come back.
¿Qué pasó en estos 8 meses?
What happened in this, during these 8 months?
De estarme visitando y visitando y visitando, se enamoró de mí.
Since she was visiting me and visiting me, she just fell in love with me.
Pero ella sabía que ese amor no estaba bien delante de Dios.
But she knew that that love was not good to the eyes of God.
Porque el Señor en su palabra le decía o le dice a ella que no podía unirse en yugo desigual.
Because in his word, God is telling her that she cannot be with a non-believer God.
Y ella empezó a decirle, Señor, tú sabes que estoy amando a este hombre.
And then she started telling to the Lord, Lord, you know that I am in love with this man.
Pero es más el mi amor por ti que lo que siento por él.
But my love for you is bigger than the love that I feel for him.
Señor, saca este sentimiento que tengo por este hombre de mi corazón.
Lord, please take out the feeling that I have for this man in my heart.
Y empezó a hacer esa oración durante 8 meses.
And then she started praying for about 8 months.
Un día abriendo su Biblia y después de orar se encontró con esta palabra.
One day, opening the Bible and after praying, she found this word.
Y ella sintió que esa palabra era para ella referente a mí.
And then she understood and she felt that this word was for her regarding me.
Pero ella le dijo al Señor en ese momento.
But then she told to the Lord in that moment.
Señor, siento que esta palabra es tuya para mí referente a este hombre.
Lord, I just feel that this word is for me regarding this man.
Pero no quiero manipular tu palabra a mis emociones.
But I don't want to manipulate your word to my emotions.
Señor, si esta palabra es tuya para mí referente a él, dame, Lord, confírmamelo de una manera sobrenatural.
If this word is for me regarding him, please confirm this word in a supernatural way.
Al domingo siguiente ya fue a su iglesia.
The next Sunday she went to her church.
Venía un predicador que jamás había estado en su iglesia.
And there was a preacher that has been never in the church.
Y por ende no la conocía a ella.
So he doesn't know her at all.
Termina este hombre de predicar, se baja del altar y se va hasta donde está ella sentada.
He finished preaching and then he went down and he goes all the way where she was sitting on.
Solamente le dijo lo siguiente, sin decirle nada más, sino que le dijo lo siguiente.
He just told her the next thing without anything else.
El Señor te dice,
the Lord is telling you,
que hagas lo que te dijo que hicieras en el libro de Hechos, capítulo 9, versículo 15.
To do what he told you to do in the book of Acts, chapter 9, verse 15.
Y ella dijo, gloria a Dios, no sé qué dijo ella.
And then she said, praise the Lord, I don't know what she said.
El hecho fue que después de 8 meses me dice, tiene visita.
After 8 months, they told me, hey, you have a visit.
Me senté.
I just took a seat.
Ella entró.
She came in.
Se vino hacia mí.
She came towards me.
Wow, como me saludó ese
and
día.
Wow, how she said hello to me that day.
¿Cómo crees que me saludó?
How do you think that she said hello to me?
No hubo beso.
There was no kiss.
No hubo Cristo te ama.
There was not even Jesus Christ.
¿Sabes cómo me saludó?
You know how to say hello?
Me quiero casar contigo.
I want to marry you.
Yo dije, wow, prefiero el otro saludo, Cristo te ama, que este.
I say, wow, I'm ready to have Jesus loves you than this hello.
El hecho fue que me casé con ella en prisión sin amarla.
So I just get married her without even loving her.
Solamente para que me visitara.
Just that she came visit me.
Me siguió visitando, terminó mi condena, me deportaron a Colombia.
She came visiting me, he finished my sentence and then deported me all the way to Colombia.
Antes de salir de una cárcel de Ogden, Oklahoma, la llamé y le di un número telefónico en Colombia.
Before I just go all the way to Colombia, I just called her from Ogden, Oklahoma in a jail and I just gave her a phone number which she
Llegué a la ciudad de Cali y al siguiente día la primera llamada que recibí era ella.
I just get to the city of Cali, and the first call that I received, and then the very next day, it was her.
Hola, mi amor, papi, ¿cómo está? Yo me quiero ir para Cali.
And she said, hello, my love, honey, how are you? I just want to go all the way to Cali.
Yo le dije, tranquila, no se me acelere. Yo voy a organizar algunas cosas, y después te puedes venir.
And then I said, take it easy, please, calm down. I'm going to organize some things, and then you may come.
Y ella me dijo, bueno, mientras tú organizas todo, dame una dirección para enviarte unos regalos.
And then she told me, okay, while you organize everything, please send me an address so I can send you some presents.
E inocentemente le di la dirección.
And just like an innocent boy, I just gave her the address.
Al tercer día,
at the third day,
tocan a la puerta.
They knock on the door.
Abro la puerta.
I open the door.
Cristo te ama.
Jesus loves you.
Yo dije, wow, ¿usted qué hace aquí?
And I said, wow, what are you doing here?
Ella me dice, ¿cómo que yo qué hago aquí?
How do you say that? What am I doing here?
Yo me casé contigo en prisión.
And then she said, I just married you in prison.
Tú eres mi esposo.
You are my husband.
Y vengo a vivir contigo.
And I came to live with you.
Yo le dije, error.
And I say, big mistake.
Yo a usted no la amo.
I don't love you.
Ese matrimonio fue una farsa.
That marriage was a fake.
Yo no quiero vivir con usted.
I don't want to live with you.
Usted puede tomar su maleta.
You may take your belongings.
Y regresarse a Estados Unidos.
And go back to USA.
En efecto, ella tomó su maleta.
In effect, yeah, she took all the belongings.
No tuvo en cuenta mi tamaño.
She doesn't care about my size.
Entró a la casa.
She get in the house.
Se apoderó de la casa.
She get in power of the house.
Y no hubo poder humano que la sacara de la casa desde ese día.
And there was no human power to take her out of the house that day.
Desde ese día.
And since that day.
Todos los días.
Every single day.
Todos los días.
Every single day.
Durante 7 años y medio.
During 7 years and a half.
Un dedo índice en mi rostro.
An index finger in my face.
Y decía, tú vas a ser un pastor, tú vas a ser un ministro de Dios.
She was telling me, you're going to be a pastor and you're going to be a minister of God.
Y yo le decía, y tú estás tostada de la cabeza.
And I just told her, you're toasted of the head.
¿Cuándo has visto un pastor con una 9 milímetros en la cintura?
How many times you have seen a pastor with a gun right here in the waist?
Todos los días.
Every single day.
7 años y medio seguido.
7 years and a half.
Yo iba a la calle y ya se quedaba de rodillas orando.
I just went out to the street and then she just stayed right there on her knees.
Yo venía de la calle y ya estaba de rodillas orando.
I just came back and she was on her knees praying as well.
7 años y medio en que no la valoré.
7 years and a half that I did not even value her.
7 años y medio en que nunca la amé.
7 years and a half that I did not even love her.
7 años y medio en que la desprecié.
7 years and a half that I just do a lot of things to her.
7 años y medio en que me vio con otras mujeres besándome y abrazándome.
7 years and a half that even she saw me with any other woman and she just saw me kissing and hugging.
Un día me halló no con cualquier mujer.
One day she just found me with not with just any woman.
Un día me halló besándome y abrazándome con su mejor amiga.
One day she saw me kissing and hugging with her best friend.
En un restaurante estábamos su mejor amiga y yo.
In a restaurant we were her best friends and myself.
Ella entró al restaurante.
She just came into the restaurant.
Se vino hasta la mesa donde estaba yo con su amiga.
She came all the way to the table where I was with her friend.
¿Sabes qué hizo?
You know what she did?
No hizo reclamos.
She doesn't did anything.
No alzó la voz.
She doesn't raise up the voice.
¿Sabes qué hizo?
You know what she did?
Abrazó a su amiga.
She just gave her a hug.
Y le dijo, amiga, te amo y te perdono.
And then she said, girlfriend, I just love you and forgive you.
Y después me abrazó a mí.
And then she gave me a hug.
Besó mis labios.
She kissed my lips.
Los labios que la estaban traicionando.
The lips that were betraying her.
Y me dijo a mí.
And then she told me.
Y a ti, amor, te amo y te perdono.
And you love, I love you and I forgive you.
7 años y medio.
7 years and a half.
Sufriendo.
Suffering.
Pero 7 años y medio aferrado a una promesa de Dios.
But 7 years and a half tied, getting tied to the promise of God.
Un día la dejé durmiendo en la calle porque se fue una vigilia en la iglesia.
One day I just let her on the street sleeping because she went to a program in the church.
Le puse seguro a la puerta.
I just locked the doors.
Al otro día me desperté, abrí la puerta y mi esposa estaba durmiendo en la calle al pie de la puerta.
The very next day I just opened the door and my wife was just sleeping right there outside the street by the door.
Cuando yo abrí la puerta,
when I opened the door,
ella se puso en pie,
she just stand up,
me dio un beso en la boca,
she gave me a kiss in the mouth,
y me dijo, papi, Cristo te amo.
And then she said, honey, Jesus loves you.
7 años y medio.
7 years and a half.
Sufriendo.
Suffering.
Pero 7 años y medio aferrado a una promesa de Dios.
But 7 years and a half getting tied to a promise of God.
7 años y medio en que iba a la iglesia y dejaba una silla vacía a su lado.
7 years and a half that she went to the church and just leave an empty chair on the side.
Cuando la gente se venía a sentar.
When the people come and try to take a seat right there.
Ella decía, no, la silla está ocupada, mi esposo está viniendo.
She said, no, the chair is not empty, my husband is about to come.
Durante 7 años y medio guardó una silla.
During 7 years and a half, she kept a chair empty.
Creyendo que algún día yo me iba a sentar en esa silla para adorar y glorificar el nombre de Dios junto con ella.
Believing that one day I was going to take a seat right there to glorify and praise the Lord just together with her.
Hace 12 años.
12 years ago.
Yo tuve un problema con ella porque se negó a estar en intimidad conmigo.
I just had a problem with her because she denied herself to be in intimacy with me.
Y yo la maltraté esa noche.
And I really treat him bad that day.
Le dije palabras muy vulgares.
I just say a lot of vulgarities.
Y con esa rabia me fui a una parte alta de la casa y miré al cielo. Por primera vez miraba al cielo.
And because I was angry, I just went to the higher place of the house and I was looking at the sky.
Y miré al cielo para hablar con el Dios de ella porque no era el Dios mío.
And I just looked at the sky and just to talk to the God of her because he wasn't my God.
Y allí mi primera conversación con Dios fue la siguiente.
And right there, my first conversation with God was the next.
Yo aún no te conozco, vos a mí no me conoces.
I don't know you and you don't know me.
Vos nunca te has metido conmigo, yo nunca me he metido con vos.
You have never been in my business and I never been in your business.
Pero yo quiero que en esta noche me demostres que sos el Dios todopoderoso que dice mi esposa que sos.
But I just want this night, you just show me that you show to me that you are the God that my wife says that you are.
Cambiame si es que me podés cambiar.
Change me if it is that you can change me.
Y si me podés cambiar,
and if you can change me,
te voy a ser fiel toda mi vida.
I'm going to be loyal to you all the life.
Pero cambiame si es que podés cambiarme.
But change me if it is that you can change me.
Al otro día me desperté.
The very next day I just wake
up. Le hablé a mi esposa y le dije, oye, necesito hablar con tu pastor.
I just called my wife and I told her, you know what? I want to talk to your pastor.
Ella se asustó mucho.
She really got scared.
Ella me dijo, lo que pasó anoche no es culpa del pastor.
And then she said, hey, what happened last night is not pastor's fault.
Ella pensó que yo iba a matar al pastor. Yo no sé qué pensó ella.
I don't know what she think, but she might be thinking that I was going to go and kill the pastor.
Yo le dije, no, yo necesito hablar con él.
And I just said, no, I just want to talk to him.
Me dio el teléfono, llamé a la iglesia de Nazareno de Cali.
She gave me the phone number and I just called the Church of Nazareth in Cali.
Dije, ¿sabe qué, pastor? Yo quiero ser líder de la iglesia.
And I just told the pastor, pastor, I want to be a leader of the church.
Yo no quería ser cristiano.
I didn't want to be a Christian.
Yo quería ser líder.
I want to be a leader.
Porque yo veía que los pastores dicen, párense, y todo el mundo se para.
Because I just saw that the pastor says, stand up, and everybody stand up.
El pastor dice, siéntense, y todo el mundo se sienta.
The pastor says, sit down, and everybody take a seat.
Yo dije, debe ser bacano ir a mandar en una iglesia,
dije
yo.
And I just said, oh, it must be so cool to go and command the church.
Él me dijo, ah, tú quieres ser líder, tienes que pasar por algunos requisitos.
Oh, and then he said, oh, you want to be a leader? You have to follow some steps.
Y uno de esos es irte a un retiro espiritual.
And one of them is just to go to a spiritual retreat.
El hecho fue que yo acepté y me fui a ese retiro espiritual.
So I accepted and I just went to that retreat.
El día que salía para el retiro espiritual puse mi Becker 9 milímetros en la cintura.
The day that when I was going out, I just put my Becker 9 millimeters in my waist.
Y puse dos proveedores 9 milímetros en la maleta.
And I just put two carriers right there in my backpack as well.
Mi esposa me dice, papi, tú no necesitas eso en la iglesia.
And then my wife says, you don't need that in the church.
Yo le dije que no, ustedes los cristianos son locos de la cabeza. Cristiano que me moleste allá, le pego su plomazo y salgo y me voy.
And I say, you say, I don't need it? Oh, yes, you Christians are kind of crazy at the head. The first one that bothered me, I just shook him and then I left.
El hecho fue que llegué a la iglesia.
The fact is that just get to the church.
Nos llevaron al lugar donde iba a ser el retiro.
They took us to the place where it's going to be the retreat.
Empezaron las enseñanzas.
Then the teachers started.
Eran 140 hombres.
There was about 140 people.
Comenzaron las enzañanzas.
And then they start the conference.
Empezaron a hablar de Jesucristo, de la cruz.
They start talking about Jesus Christ, about the cross.
El de aquí lloraba, el de allá lloraba, el otro lloraba.
The one here cried, this one cried, and the other one cried.
Yo decía, ¿yo qué hago con este poco de llorones aquí, compadre?
And I just said, what am I doing with this bunch of cries right here?
Y el hecho fue que siguieron los temas.
So the deal is that all the conferences keep going and keep going.
El día domingo termina está terminando el retiro y da la palabra el pastor Adalberto.
The Sunday, the retreat was about to get to the end, and Pastor Alberto comes and gives the last one.
Hablan del Espíritu Santo, yo no entendí nada.
He speak about the Holy Spirit, and I didn't understand anything.
Él dice, cuando termina, pónganse de pie todos, vamos a orar.
And when he finished, he said, everybody stand up, we're going to pray.
Y como siempre, todo el mundo se puso de pie.
And like always, everybody stand up.
Yo me quedé sentado en la última silla.
But I stayed in my seat.
Me quitaron la silla y me tuve que parar.
So they pulled my chair and I have to stand up.
Y el pastor Alberto dice, levanten la mano, cierren los ojos todos.
And Pastor Alberto says, oh, lift up your hands and close your eyes.
Vamos a orar.
We're going to pray.
Yo metí las manos al bolsillo tocando mis proveedores de la pistola.
I just put my hands in my pocket touching the carriers of my gun.
Todo el mundo levantó las manos, cerró los ojos.
Everybody just lift up their hands and close their eyes.
Y el pastor Alberto me mira ya de último con los ojos abiertos y las manos en los bolsillos.
And then the pastor Alberto just saw me right there on the back with my eyes open and my hands
y
in
se
my
viene
pockets.
Hacia mí.
And he came towards me.
El pastor Alberto es pequeño de estatura.
Pastor Alberto is kind of shorty.
Y me dice, levanta tus manos, cierra tus ojos.
And then he came and told me, lift up your hands and close your eyes.
Yo me agaché a la estatura de él.
I just get down all the way to his tight.
Con mi manos en el bolsillo.
With my hands in my pockets.
Y le dije, no voy a levantar las manos.
And I told him, I will not lift up my
hands. Y no voy a cerrar mis ojos.
I will not close my eyes.
Porque el Dios de ustedes.
Because your God.
Me tiene que demostrar que es poderoso con mis manos abajo y mis ojos abiertos. No.
Needs to show me so that he's so powerful with my hands down and my eyes open. No.
Y todo el mundo volteó a mirar.
So everybody look at me.
Y el pastor Alberto, sigan orando, no se distraigan, sigan orando.
And the pastor says, keep praying, keep praying. Don't get distracted.
Siguieron orando.
So they keep praying.
Hasta que un momento sin yo querer levanté mis manos.
Until one moment without my will, I just lift up my hands.
Y cuando yo me vi con las manos levantadas,
and when I saw myself with my hands up,
yo hice fuerza para bajar mis manos.
I really tried so hard to put them down.
Pero ese día,
but that day,
siendo yo un hombre fuerte,
even though I was so strong,
ese día yo intenté con todas mis fuerzas bajar las manos.
I tried so hard to put them down.
Pero a pesar de que yo era fuerte,
but even though I was so strong,
ese día me encontré con alguien más fuerte que yo.
That day I had an encounter with someone that was stronger than me.
Porque no pude bajar mis manos.
Because I couldn't put down my hands.
Y con mis manos levantadas,
and with my hands all the way lifted up,
empecé a sentir ganas de cerrar mis ojos.
I start feeling the need to.
Pero cada vez que cerraba mis ojos,
but every time I close my eyes,
sentía ganas de llorar.
I just feel that I want to cry.
Y me acordaba lo que me dijo un tío.
And I just remember what
los hombres no lloran.
Men don't cry.
Y volví a abrir los ojos.
And then I opened my eyes again.
Pero llegó un momento en que no pude abrir más mis ojos.
But then the moment comes when I couldn't open my eyes anymore.
Y empecé a llorar, a llorar, a llorar y a llorar.
And then I started crying and crying and crying.
36 años en que no lloraba.
36 years that I never cried.
Y estaba yo ahí llorando con mis manos arriba sin poderlas bajar.
And I was right there crying with my hands all the way up and I couldn't put it down.
Y vino alguien y me abrazó.
And then somebody comes and give me a hug.
Yo no sentí el abrazo de un hombre ese día porque fue un hombre muy joven el que me abrazó.
I didn't feel the hug of a man that day because he was so young, a young man.
Yo no sentí el abrazo de un hombre.
I didn't feel the hug of a man.
Yo sentí el abrazo de esa mamá que nunca me abrazó.
I just feel that my mom was hugging me, the one that never gave me a hug.
Yo sentí el abrazo de ese papá que nunca me abrazó.
I just feel the hug of that father that never gave me a hug.
Y este hombre me dice, ¿quieres recibir a Cristo en tu corazón?
This young boy told me, would you like to accept Jesus Christ in your heart?
Yo le dije, sí, yo necesito a Cristo en mi corazón.
Then I said, yes, I do need Jesus Christ in my heart.
Y él me llevó a hacer una oración muy sencilla, pero que hoy entiendo que es muy poderosa.
And then he led me through a prayer that was so simple, but now I understand that it's so powerful.
Y cuando yo confesé en medio de esa oración a Jesucristo como mi Señor y Salvador,
and when I confessed that prayer to Jesus Christ and I accept that he was my only Savior,
en ese momento ese Félix lleno de odio, de maldad, de venganza murió.
In that moment, that Felix full of revenge and the heinous, he died right there.
Y nació el nuevo Félix que están viendo ustedes en esta mañana, and en este lugar.
The new Felix that you are watching in this place was born again.
Termina ese tiempo.
Then that time finished.
Me regreso a casa caminando.
And I just go to the house again by walking.
Pasé por el río Cali, tiré proveedores, tiré munición, tiré arma al río Cali, renuncié a las armas.
I just passed through the Cali River and I just dropped my guns. I just dropped the carries and any part of that I was carrying in that.
Y le dije a Dios, Señor, renuncio a las armas, ahora mi arma eres tú.
And then I told the Lord, I will not use the weapons again. Not my weapon is you.
Y empecé a caminar hacia la casa.
So I start walking all the way to the house.
Toqué a la puerta de la casa.
I knock at the door.
Salió ella.
And then she came out.
La vi más hermosa que nunca ese día.
I just saw her more beautiful than ever that day.
Mientras el pecado cubría mis ojos, nunca la vi hermosa.
While the sea was covering my eyes, I never saw her that
day. Pero ese día sin el pecado cubriendo mis ojos,
but that day without the scene covering my eyes,
pude darme cuenta que tenía la mujer más hermosa en casa.
I just understood that I have the woman most beautiful in the house.
Y ella vino y yo le dije, ella venía y le dije, acabo de conocer a tu Dios.
And then she came and I just told her, I just met your God.
Ahora tu Dios es mi Dios.
Now your God is my God.
Porque vive en mi corazón.
Because he lives in my heart.
Ella vino y me abrazó.
She came and gave me a hug.
Y mientras me abrazaba, yo le dije, por favor, perdóname.
And while she was giving me a hug, I just told her, please forgive me.
Nunca le había pedido perdón.
I never asked.
Pero ese día con Cristo en mi corazón le pedí perdón.
But that day with Jesus Christ in my heart, I just asked her for forgiveness.
Le dije, por favor, perdóname.
And I just told her, please forgive me.
Y después le dije, yo a ti no te amo.
And then I told her, you know what, I don't love you.
Porque yo no la amaba a ella.
Because I didn't love her.
Le dije, yo a ti no te amo.
And I told her, I don't love you.
Pero tú te mereces ser amada.
But you deserve to be loved.
Dame una oportunidad, una sola oportunidad.
Give me one chance, just one chance.
Para amarte porque tú te mereces ser amado.
To love you because you deserve to be loved.
Y desde ese día,
and since that day,
la empecé a amar.
I started loving her.
Y la amo.
And I love 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 her.
Porque Cristo cambió mi corazón.
Because Jesus changed my heart.
Termino de hablar con mi esposa y subo al segundo piso.
I just finished talking with my wife and I came into the second floor.
Entré a una habitación que durante 5 años nunca había entrado.
And I just get into the room that I, even during 5 years I have never been inside.
Una habitación que tenía una criatura de 5 años que jamás me importó este niño.
A room that has a creature of 5 years old and I never even care about this kid.
Nunca había entrado a su habitación.
I have never been in that.
No me importaba nunca
room.
El niño.
I not even care about this child.
Pero ese día con Cristo en mi corazón.
But that day with Jesus Christ in my heart.
Por primera vez entré a la habitación.
My first time I just
me fui hasta la cama donde estaba un niño de 5 años.
And I just went all the way to the bed when there was a creature of 5 years old.
Por primera vez abracé al niño.
My first time I just gave him a hug.
Era mi hijo mayor.
It was my older self.
Yo nunca lo había abrazado.
I never hugged him before.
Porque papá nunca me abrazó.
Because my father never gave me a hug.
Lo empecé a besar en su frente.
I started kissing him in the face.
Yo nunca lo había besado.
I never kissed him before.
Porque papá nunca me besó.
Because my father never kissed.
Pero ese día con Cristo en mi corazón.
But that day with Jesus Christ in my
tuve la libertad para ir a abrazar a mi hijo.
Was set free just to go and give him a hug.
Tuve la libertad para ir a besar a mi hijo.
I had freedom to go and kiss my
y mientras
son.
Lo besaba y lo abrazaba.
And when I was kissing him and hugging him,
le dije, hijo, perdóname.
I just told his son, please
perdóname,
forgive me,
hijo.
Forgive me, my son.
Por no ser el padre que tú te mereces.
Because I was not the father that you deserve.
Y el niño no entendía nada.
Child doesn't understand anything.
Pero yo estaba siendo libre al pedirle perdón a mi hijo.
I was getting into the freedom when I was telling him.
Estaba yo abrazando a mi hijo y entra mi esposa con un teléfono en la mano.
I was hugging my son when my wife came in with a phone in the hand.
¿Estás seguro que tienes a Cristo en tu corazón?
Then she said, are you sure that you have Jesus Christ in your heart?
Yo le dije, sí, yo estoy seguro.
And then I said, yes, I'm so sure.
Demuéstramelo.
And then she said, show me.
Me pasó el teléfono.
She gave me the phone.
Yo dije aló.
And I said hello.
Al otro lado una mujer dijo aló.
On the other side another woman says hello.
Y yo dije ¿quién habla?
And then I say who's this?
Y me dice Elisa.
And then she say Elisa.
Wow, Elisa.
And I say wow, Elisa.
36 años odiando a Elisa.
36 years hating Elisa.
36 años en que nunca volví a ver a Elisa.
36 years that I have never even seen Elisa again.
36 años en que nunca hablé con Elisa.
36 that I even spoke with Elisa.
Elisa era mi mamá.
Elisa was my mother.
Y le dije, hola mamá.
And I say, hello mother.
Ella me dice, ¿quién habla?
And then she say, who's this?
Yo le digo, Félix.
And then I say, Félix.
No, no me mientan, Félix no me llamaría.
Please don't lie to me. Felix will never call.
Le digo, sí, mamá, soy yo. Acabo de conocer a Cristo y Cristo cambió mi corazón.
Yes, mother, it's me. Jesus changed my life. He is in my heart.
Y le dije, ¿sabes qué, mamá? Te perdono todo el daño que me hiciste.
Then I told her, yes, mother, and you know what? I forgive you all the pain that you caused in my life.
Y ¿sabes qué, mamá? Te pido perdón por todo el odio que te tuve.
And please, mother, forgive me for all the hate that I have against you.
Termino de hablar con mamá, le paso el teléfono a mi esposa.
And then I finish talking with my mom and I give him back the phone to my spouse.
Ella me dice, no, demuéstrame que tienes a Cristo en tu corazón.
And then she said, no, just show me that you have Jesus Christ in your heart.
Yo le dije, ya te demostré.
And then I told her, yeah, I'll already show you.
Ella me tomó el teléfono y le dijo a mi mamá, pásenme al papá de Félix.
And then she took the phone and then she said, you know what, Elisa, please, get me the father of Felix.
Me pasó el teléfono.
She gave me the phone.
Al hombre que nunca le llamé, papá.
To the man that I not even call him.
Al hombre que odiaba con todas las fuerzas de mi corazón.
To the man that I hate with all the strength of my
Al hombre que muchas noches quise ir a matarlo en su casa.
The man that I, many nights I just want to go and kill
him. Estaba al otro lado del teléfono.
It was on the other side of
Nunca le dije papá.
I never called him father.
Pero ese día cuando tomé el teléfono.
But that day when I took the phone.
Y con Cristo en mi corazón.
And with Jesus Christ in my heart.
Mi primera palabra con él.
My first word with him was.
Hola papá.
Hello father.
Y ese día
and that day,
le pedí perdón.
I asked him for forgiveness.
Y ese día
and that day,
pude perdonar a mi papá.
I forgive my father.
El día que yo recibí a Cristo en mi corazón.
That day that I received Jesus Christ in my
Él restauró mi matrimonio.
He restored my marriage.
Él restauró mi relación con mi hijo.
He restored my relationship with my
Él
son.
Restauró la relación con papá y la relación con mamá.
He restored my relationship with my father and my mother.
Y él restauró completamente mi vida.
And he restored my completely my life.
Porque Jesucristo es especialista en restauraciones.
Because Jesus Christ is a specialist in restoration.
Es el único que puede restaurar.
He is the only one who can
Es el único
restore.
Que puede sanar.
He is the only one who can heal.
Y él está hoy en este lugar.
And he is today in this place.
Su espíritu está en este lugar.
His Holy Spirit is in this place.
Y él quiere restaurar
And
en
he
este
wants
lugar.
To restore this place.
Él quiere volver a empezar en la vida de todos nosotros.
He wants to start again in the life of every one of us.
Porque su palabra dice.
Because his word says.
Que sus misericordias son nuevas cada mañana.
That his mercy is new every single morning.
Él todos los días lo hace nuevo.
He do everything, every day new.
Porque él quiere que todos los días estemos renovándonos y renovándonos y renovándonos.
He wants to be renewed every single day and every single day be renewed.
Yo tengo convencido de que Cristo es el que sostiene mi vida.
I am convinced that the one who can hold my life is Jesus Christ.
Y hace 12 años renuncié a un trabajo del narcotráfico.
And 12 years ago I just run away and go away from the
arriesgándome que me mataran por salirme del
risking
negocio.
Risking my life even because they were going to kill me because I went out of their job.
Pero defendí mi posición de Cristo.
But I defend my position of Jesus Christ.
Defendí de que yo quería cambiar de mi vida.
I just defend that I wanted to change my life.
Y no me mataron.
And they didn't kill me.
Porque cuando Cristo está contigo,
because when Jesus Christ is with you,
Cristo pone gracia aún en los pecadores.
Jesus put the grace even in the sinners.
Hace 12 años
12 years ago,
vendí todo lo que tenía todo
I sold everything that I have, everything.
Todo el dinero que tenía mal habido todo vendí
all the bad money that I have, I just put it away.
Compré 25 casas nuevas
I buy 25 houses.
Y compré 25 taxis 0 kilómetros taxis
and I bought, 25 taxis, 0 kilometers.
Y con mi esposa regalamos esas 25 casas y esos 25 taxis a familias pobres.
And with that, those, with my wife, together with my wife, we just gave away to poor families those 25 houses and those 25 taxis.
Y empecé a servirle al Señor de cero.
So I start serving my Lord with zero.
Hace 12 años.
12 years ago.
Trabajo únicamente para Dios.
I just work only for my God.
Y Él es el que me sostiene.
And that's, he's the one who get a hold.
Él sostiene a mi esposa.
He's the only one who
Él sostiene a mis hijos.
He's get a hold my sons, my
Porque
children.
Dios es poderoso.
Because he is so powerful.
Y Él está en esta mañana, en este lugar.
And he is in this morning, in this place.
Y yo quiero preguntar en esta mañana.
And I just want to ask you this morning.
¿Habrá alguien aquí que no tenga a Cristo en su corazón?
Would there be somebody that doesn't have Jesus Christ in their heart?
Okay.
Okay.
Todos tienen a Cristo en su corazón.
Everybody have Jesus Christ in their heart.
¿Cuántos tienen a Cristo en su corazón?
How many of you have Jesus Christ in their heart?
Les puedo hacer una pregunta que me hicieron hace 12 años.
May I ask you a question that they made me 12 years ago?
¿Estás seguro que tienes a Cristo en tu corazón?
Are you sure that you have Jesus Christ in your heart?
¿Estás seguro?
Are you sure?
Porque si tú me dices que tienes a Cristo en tu corazón,
because if you are so sure that you have Jesus Christ in your heart,
y no has podido perdonar a alguien que te hizo daño,
and if you couldn't forgive somebody that hurt you before,
te quiero decir algo.
I just want to tell you something.
Tú necesitas a Cristo en tu corazón.
You need Jesus Christ in your heart.
¿Habrá alguien que necesite a Cristo en su corazón?
Would there be somebody that needs Jesus Christ in their heart?
Si no has podido perdonar a alguien, aquí está el altar.
If you haven't forgiven somebody that hurt you before, here's the altar.
Para que tú salgas de allá y vengas al altar de Dios.
So you can come up from your place and come to the altar and praise the Lord.
Hace 12 años yo me tuve que rendir a Jesucristo.
12 years ago I had to surrender all to Jesus.
Yo no quería levantar las manos.
I didn't want to rise up my hands.
Pero me rendí ante Jesucristo.
But I just surrendered before the Lord.
¿Habrá alguien que necesite a Jesús en su casa?
Would there be somebody that needs Jesus Christ in the house?
¿Habrá alguien que necesite restauración en alguna área de su vida?
Would there be somebody that needs restoration in any area of the life?
Acá está el altar para que pases.
Here is the altar so you can come.
En esta mañana no importa el que dirán.
And this morning it doesn't matter what the people is going to say.
En esta mañana lo que importa es que Jesús trabaje en tu corazón.
What matters in this morning is that Jesus work in your heart.
Esta mañana antes de venir para acá.
This morning before I came here.
Y el pastor sabe lo que le voy a decir.
And the pastor knows what I'm going to tell you.
Hoy cumple años un hombre que me ha hecho en estos últimos días mucho daño.
Today is the birthday of a man that hurt me a lot on these days.
Y es la fecha de su cumpleaños.
And it is the birthday today.
Y por un momento yo dije, no voy a felicitarlo en este día.
And for one moment I said, I will not say some happy birthdays or anything to this day.
Y en ese momento cuando yo dije, no voy a felicitarlo en este día.
At that moment when I say I will not send any congratulations or anything to this man.
Porque me está haciendo daño, dije.
Because he's hurting me right now.
No lo voy a felicitar.
I will not say congratulations.
Inmediatamente abrí la Biblia.
Immediately I just opened the Bible.
Y sentí Dios diciéndome algo.
I just felt God telling me something.
Felicítalo en este día.
Just go and congratulate him this day.
No importa lo que te haya hecho.
It doesn't matter what he has done to you.
Porque tú me has hecho cosas más graves que lo que él te ha hecho a ti.
Because you have done worse things than what he is doing to you.
Y siempre estoy ahí para felicitarte.
And I'm always right there to congratulate you.
Siempre estoy ahí para decirte bien hecho, Félix.
I'm always right there to tell you well done, good job, Félix.
Y tuve que decirle feliz cumpleaños a esta persona.
I had to wish him a happy birthday to this.
Tuve que decirle que Dios conceda los deseos de tu corazón.
And I have to tell him that God concedes all the desires of your heart.
Y este hombre me dice.
And this man just told me.
De todas las felicitaciones de este día.
Of all the congratulations of this day.
Esta es la más importante, Félix.
This is the most important, Félix.
Muchas gracias por amar.
Thank you so much for love.
Aún en medio de lo que te estoy causando.
Even in the middle of what I'm causing you.
Cosas tan pequeñas.
Such a little things.
Que necesitan ser traídas al altar de Dios.
To bring to the altar.
¿Habrá alguien que necesite pasar al altar en esta mañana?
Would there be somebody that needs to come to the altar in this morning?
Vamos a orar en esta mañana.
Let's pray in this morning.
Yo les pido que se pongan de pie.
Please, I ask you if you may stand up.
Padre celestial, en esta mañana.
God Heavenly Father, this morning.
Como pueblo tuyo, como hijos tuyos, estamos delante de ti.
Like your people, like your children, we are before you.
Padre, presentamos nuestros corazones, Dios.
Father, we present our hearts to you.
Señor, mira dentro de nuestros corazones.
Father, look inside our hearts.
Y si hay algo dentro de nuestros corazones.
And if there is something inside our heart,
que no esté de acuerdo con lo que tú quieres.
That is not according to what you.
Si hay algo dentro de nuestros corazones que se interpone en nuestra relación contigo, por favor, sácala de nuestro corazón. Límpianos, purifícanos, lávanos. Te lo pedimos en el nombre de Jesús. Tú nos has llamado a ser la luz de este mundo. Pero si hay algo oscuro en nuestro corazón, esa luz no va a alumbrar. Saca todo lo que haya en nuestros corazones para poder alumbrar cuando salgamos de este lugar. Y para que la gente pueda ver en nosotros el reflejo del Hijo de Dios.
reflect of the Son of God.
Y para que puedan hablarnos y decirnos.
So they can talk to us and tell us.
Usted tiene la forma de un ángel.
You have the form of an angel.
Sus palabras son de un ángel.
Your words are like an angel.
Su mirada es de un ángel.
Your look is like the one angel.
Porque yo tuve un ángel.
Because I have an angel.
Durante 7 años y medio.
During 7 years and a half.
En que nunca dejó de brillar.
That never stopped shining.
Porque siempre estaba mostrando.
Because she always showed.
Tu gloria.
Your glory.
Y tu luz.
And your light.
Gracias, Señor.
Thank you, Lord.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen.
Say we thank the Lord today. Lord, we thank you so much for the great testimony of life change that's taken place in a man that we can see you shining through his life. Holy Spirit, I believe you've used his story, maybe just one aspect of his story, to touch an area in our lives today. And we want to open up our heart and our mind to you today. Lord, all I know is that we're in a place, a great place of great love, a place where you're pouring down upon us in an incredible way. And on this day, that you've given us a gift today to experience, to be renewed, to know that you are in the changing business of taking lives that are broken, that are hurt, and to mend them, to change us, and to save us. Today, Lord, I just want to make sure my heart, search my heart and know me. Would you pray that prayer today? Would you allow God to search your heart right where you're at? You say, Dustin, you're pushing. That's exactly right, because I feel the Holy Spirit just saying, pause for just a moment. Lord, would you just check us today? All we know is that we want to seek your perfect will for our lives. We wouldn't be here if we didn't desire to serve you. Lord, I thank you for a great family of God that loves you. But I wonder if there's a foothold, if there's a plank in the eye, if there's unforgiveness that's taken place in some hearts and lives. And today, you want to change us. Lord, you've been so faithful to us, just like Felix's wife is so faithful to him. Never giving up. Lord, thank you for not giving up on our lives either. And it's my prayer today that there would not be a man leave here today without knowing that you are the Lord of his life. There's maybe been some brokenness in his life. Maybe he's not been faithful. Maybe no one knows about it. But he knows. Lord, you want to change him. You want to save him. And so, Lord Jesus, we take our hands out of the pocket. We lift them up to you. We say, Jesus, we want you to be first in our lives. Sir, if that's you today, would you lift your hand up to the Lord today? Say, Lord, would you save me from my sins? Would you come into my life? Would you just change who I am? Ladies, maybe the same goes for you. Don't miss out. God has a blessing he wants to give to you. He wants to mend the brokenhearted. He wants to heal the family. Today is the day of salvation. Would you raise your hand up to the Lord today? Maybe there's someone in the church, and you've been in the church a long time, and you've allowed some hardness to come in. And all I know is, Jesus, I want to raise my hand up and say, would you melt this heart of stone, and would you come into my life, and would you change me? I surrender it all to you. And today is the day of salvation. The Lord knows. He sees your hand. And yes, I believe there's some who maybe want to come and kneel at the altar. That would be very appropriate. Maybe you want to reach over and take a loved one by the hand and say, would you forgive me today? And would you come into my life? And would you, let me speak. Would you come into my life? And would you allow Jesus to change your heart today? Oh God, you are a God of not of confusion, but God, you are a God who wants to change lives. And today we seek your face. And families, I believe that the Lord wants to do something incredible. And so we seek your way, your will today. Lord, we thank you. And it's our prayer today that you would just do your perfect will, your perfect work in our lives. So we seek you today. Are all hearts clear? All minds today? Jesus first in life. John, could we sing that song, I Surrender All?